morning. Today I'm going to be speaking about the, I'm going to call them UBI, they're called the Universal Basic Income. Now this is not a new concept, it's a concept that's happened since many centuries now, since the 16th century. Thomas More mentioned this, that without Utopia, Utopia can't exist without a governmental income given to the people. So, that's really the concept, and we have to go beyond concept and actually bring it into action. At this point in time, it's all been concept, it's been talk, it's been discussion, it's like, yes, maybe we can do it, but then there seems to be this fear hold that has stopped it. In Switzerland, there was a referendum, and they tried to pass it. 25% agreed to it, and yet there was still an overwhelming 76% that decided to naysay it. So when we're looking at the naysayers, we have to figure out, tapping into them, is why are you naysaying? Okay, but maybe they're scared of the principle itself. They're scared of what UBI represents. They're thinking it's just going to be a system of loafers, okay? Of loafers and sluffer offers, or people who don't aspire. It will bring desuccessionism. It will bring us into moments of lazy, lackadaisical. I believe that's where they're coming from when they're putting their little check or their pinpoint on the vote, on that voting moment. I believe that's where they're coming from, is they believe that it's going to be a non-deserved give out, where they have worked in their lifetime, and why shouldn't you likewise do the same? You know what I'm saying? Why shouldn't you do the same struggles that I struggled at? You know, why should you receive a handout? So that's what I'm addressing. Okay. With the UBI. Okay. We can't even look at people as they are today, right now. We can't look at the poor class as they are today. We can't look at the criminal class as they are today. Under a UBI system, you cannot make the same assumptions. It is an evolution that will happen. When you are in a UBI system, you will have those old people that were living by their same routines, their same routine of being criminal, their same routines of being impoverished, of being uneducated. They will be in those same routines, okay? But when under the UBI system, those routines will modify. The criminal doesn't have that reason to steal as much, does he? He doesn't have that reason any longer. He's supplied. He has a stipend. So why would he risk it? You know, if he has the stipend coming in, that's less criminals. Okay, so we're bringing less criminal element into the society. Not right away, okay, because these people are, how should I say it? Born and bred into the current economy, born and bred into the current system that has taught them to be the way they are. So they have to relearn out of the old system and into the new UBI. Okay, that they have cash in their account, that they have options, that they have choices. They do not have to steal. There's no reason for them to do that. They have housing. So big whoa goes off in their head and that will be a change in them. So the criminal class will have fewer reasons to steal. Okay. Now, who else is affected there? We have the poverty class, the impoverished people. Well, right now they're a lug on many economies around the world. They are a lug because they require food stamps. They require government buildings built just to accommodate all of the impoverished needs. The people of poverty, they need this and they need that handled for them because they're uneducated, because they require emergency housing needs, all kinds of these things are a lug on the system. And they require people to even work in those jobs as social welfare workers, etc. All right, so here we are at that poverty class is going to change. You see that? In poverty class, it won't have that same hit at governments any longer. It would be given. Now, I'm not saying the direction it's given is correct. It's just handed out. I do not believe in that one bit. I believe it has to have a direction. You have to give money with a direction. Okay. So, when you hand out the money to this poverty class, you know, they can rush out and spend it and be stupid. Or you give them a direction. Okay. Because in an essence, they're not educated on how to spend that money. So we have to educate them on how to spend the money. And that's through direction. So we direct them and we say, you use it towards your housing, and we give them a specific amount. You use it towards your food supplies, and we give them a specific amount. You use it towards your clothing, you get a specific amount. Big expenditures, those would be ID quantified, so mafias don't start up about it. You would have any large expenditure over $300, say, would have to be run through. This happened through you. You know, it'll be a responsibility card that we would all carry. So you couldn't have like a mafia hitting 3 or 4 or 20 people again and again. That's what these small little credit mafias do. So they couldn't do that. They wouldn't have that procedure. They wouldn't be allowed. They wouldn't be able to tap into your cash. Okay. So here we are, and so we have the poverty class now as being directed on how to spend it, okay, rather than like we have this new Andrew Yang who's going for president, and that's wonderful, and he's bringing UBI into the spotlight, and it's fabulous, but is his UBI the correct one? Is it the right way to go? Is it directed enough? Is it giving, people are like, is it giving, here's this rush of money like a river, is it directing them down the correct channel? You know what I'm saying? It has to be given a clause, there has to be clauses in there on how to spend it. Now, I updated my version of the prepaid wage with a chart, because maybe charts are easier for people to understand, but I've had it out there for many years and I haven't had a nibble or a bite, but perhaps it's time for the world to start realizing that we're going to change as human beings, and in order to get to this utopia we're going to change, and we can have that right here, right in the near future. We can modify ourselves as human beings, we can remove ourselves from criminal, we we can elevate the poverty class. Now, when I say elevate, this give of money is an elevation. It is a reason for them to be like, take care of their home. They will have a home. They will be able to buy a home. It is a reason for them to have an uplift. It is a reason for them to stop swearing. They would be in an elevated, I hate to say it, a class structure. We will be building a new class structure. One that is not the lower life, one that is a chance at scholar, one that gives us money to actually spend in going to school. Okay? So in the beginning, you cannot expect this group, I will call them lowlifes, you cannot expect the group of lowlifes to switch into being elevated class. You can't expect that right away. But it will happen. It'll happen, and for some, quickly. When that woman it has the house, it happens quickly. When that woman has no reason to steal, it happens quickly. Do you understand? We'll have less purse snatchers. All of this kind of garbage that's been going on in the past will disappear. Okay. So now we're going to address, but wait a minute, they don't work very much. How does that help? And yes, we know for some reason it still is a bonus to the economy, and it still gives businesses more money, this type of supply to the poverty class. How is this possible? It just does. Financially, it increases money in businesses, it increases money in government. We are absolutely losing money by this group. This group has been the one, is the crime syndicates. This has been the group of just nothing. They have not done a thing. Do you understand what I'm saying? When I say a thing, they haven't done anything to help society. They hinder society. They hinder society's progress. And I don't mean building buildings and doing manual labor. I mean they've hindered progress as a human brain evolvement. We haven't been able to evolve out of those low lives. Those low lives exist. So we haven't been able to bring the human race out of low life-ism. Okay. So. Now, one generation, two generations, three generations forward through a UBI is looking like, wow, we're new people. We are a new people. We're a constructivism, I will say. We are a constructed group. We are using a constructed brain, a brain of, let's construct this way. Let's construct this that way. Let's think this way. Let's think that way. We are more excited about the direction of us as human beings. You understand? Rather than it's just my life and I need this now. Give me this for greed's sake. That dissipates. That goes away. Even though here, well, you've been given the handout, it doesn't matter. That handout offers you a pause. It offers you a pause, not just spend. It offers you a moment to say, hey, what am I doing with my life? Where am I going? I have chances. I have challenges. I have like huge options that I didn't have before. Okay. So this low-life person, this low-life group, changes. Their brains are like, whoa, getting turned into something else. Okay. So it's a we become a constructionism society. about where we are headed, about where we are headed, and how we can further our utopia for this planet and this earth and the people around us. Okay. So we have to, for all this to happen, we have to remove the fear hold of UBI from those voters. And I will say, I can't say it's the old class of people, blah, 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 that have been voting Republican or voting this or voting that. I can't say that. I don't even know who they are. In some cases, it can be the manual labor people themselves saying, no way, I worked, I struggled. You're going to do it also. You know, it can be this small brain that would reject it. Do you understand? So if we have small brains rejecting it, we need to teach those brains. We have to teach them that, hey, no, it is a way forward. Now let's discuss pollution reduction. Yang apparently is not doing well on his ecology stats, I'm very disappointed with that, but I believe in his version, I didn't read it all in entirety, it looked a little bit like it was a VAT tax or sales tax oriented, where from your give, you're taxed out on your spends. So that's his version. Now the other versions are often property tax funded, and I don't mean property tax, I mean property sales tax. Like you sold your house, you take a sales tax, a hefty one, because that pays for all of our prepaid wages. Okay, so that's my version. And that way, one I like, because you end up with also money extra to buy a house, get into a mortgage. So what was I talking about? So yeah, we have these, and then ecology itself, you know, there has to be money from the taxation that's made, that's built into this type of government. There has to be enough taxation that ecology is accounted for. There has to be enough for ecology, for military, because we have a lot of military we have to continue maintaining and demaintaining and reducing. All of that costs money. Okay, so we have to reduce and maintain. So we need the 20, we need hefty tax. That's why mine was so high at 25. Okay. But we don't have to tax businesses. We don't have to tax we don't need an income tax. We just need to do it through certain things. Okay, certain things only. I mentioned utility companies. I mentioned banking institutions, casinos, churches, all of these as being taxed. And back to the sale of your property, $1 million property reduces down to $750. And you know, you don't get the $250 extra. That goes into the tax. And that pays for the system. So what it may seem hefty to you now isn't in the long run. It, in a way, people be like, I'm so happy, I can buy houses in my lifetime. I can buy several. And in that option of buying several, I'm glad to give that property sales tax to the government. It'll be a new brain, don't you get it? A new brain that will be happy to give that in. Because in a way, it's just like, you know, we have all these good donation companies, we're donating for this, we're donating for that. There's no reason why a government should not be a donation into experience. That makes us profitable. That makes us profitable and successful as human beings. Because right now we feel like I've got to give income tax into what? To fighting just everything under the sun? I don't want to do that any longer. You know? I want it to be a successful experience. Okay. So, Tantria. Anyway, UBI. We need to sell it. We need to sell it. We need to sell it. And we need to sell it. That's it. Full stop. And even if Andrew doesn't have the most ecological version right now, it does not matter. get his foot in the door, get him talking about it, get it into the White House, get it into the presidency. We can fight all the logistics of the UBI once it's there. All of the little moments, we can change it around once it's there. That makes it easy. Then it's just like, bring out the mathematicians, let's have fun with this, you know. But we need to get it into the White House. All right, end of story today for me.